Let's start. So, seventh question we have discussed. Eighth question we have to discuss. Okay. In the following figures, the side AB and BC and the median AD of a triangle ABC are respectively equal to the side PQ, QR and the median PS of the triangle PQR. Okay. So here two separate triangles are given to us. ABC and PQR. Okay. At last, we have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. So a triangle ABC is given and PQR is given. Okay. What more information is given? Side AB, BC, and the median AD of the triangle. So we are having on median as well. Here median means this is the median. Okay. These two are equal. Midpoint of the opposite side joined to the vertex. Similarly here, these two are equal. This is the median. Okay. So in the following figure, sides AB, BC, and AD of the triangle are respectively equal to the side PQ, QR, and median PS. It means AB is equal to PQ. AB. This side is equal to this side PQ. It is given. BC is equal to QR. BC. This equal to QR, it means half of that as well equal. Yes. BC is equal to QR. Therefore, BD equal to QS as well. Okay. So they are equal. And the median AD of the triangle ABC, median AD is equal to median PS. Median AD equal to PS. Okay. And we have to prove ABC triangle is congruent to triangle PQR. So how you are going to prove it? Anyone in class?
So how we got QS is equal to SR?
How we got QS equal to SR? Okay, what is written? AD is what here? Okay, for example, how you got BD equal to DC? How you got BD equal to DC here? AD is median of the triangle ABC. AD is the median. And what does median mean? If we draw a triangle, and for example, ABC, I have to draw a median from vertex A on side BC. So how we draw the median? Median means first you have to take the midpoint of this side. It means this part equal to this side. We have to divide this side into two equal parts. Okay. Then join to the opposite vertex. This is the median. Similarly, PS here is the median. Median means these two parts are.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. Okay. If we want to prove them, we can prove AB equal to PQ, BC equal to QS. Two sides we can prove. Two sides we can prove, but we need one more extra part, maybe angle or the side. So how we can prove? Can we prove?
Sir, first we can prove PQS is congruent, and then we can prove PQR.
Yes. So what we are going to do? See here. Mute yourself once. Okay. So see here. If we try to prove triangle ABC congruent to PQR, we have only two information, that is AB equal to PQ, one side, BC equal to QR, second side, okay? Rest, we won't be able to prove. That is, one more angle or one more side, we are not able to prove, okay? That they are equal or they are congruent. So for that, what we require first? First, we need one more information, either the side or the for the angle. So for that, first, what we are going to do? We are going to prove that these two triangles are congruent. We can easily prove these two triangles are congruent.
Yes, sir.
We can easily prove these two by which theorem we can prove? See here, this side equals this side, this side equals this side. SSS theorem. By SSS theorem, we can prove these two triangles are congruent, these smaller ones. As smaller triangles are congruent, all the remaining angles, corresponding angles will be equal. It means we require this angle. Yes or no? This angle will be equal to this angle as well. So this angle will be equal to this angle. We got the angle. Now, this angle is also the part of the bigger triangle. This angle is as well the part of the bigger triangle. So now we can prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. How? Side equal to side, side equal to side, and this angle equal to this angle by SAS theorem. By SAS theorem. Okay, do everyone in their notebook. Complete it. Start doing. So first prove smaller triangles. So triangle ABD. And take triangle ABD and triangle PQS. Take these two triangles and prove them to be congruent. AB equal to PQ given. BD equal to QS. It is also given. You can write given, or you can write BD equal to half of BC, QS equal to half of QR, and BC equal to QR. That reason you can write, or you can write given. That's no issue. Third one, AD equal to PS. It is given as well. So by which theorem they are congruent? ABD triangle PQS by SSS. By SSS theorem, they are congruent. Okay, we have proved them to be congruent. And what we require to prove ABC triangle congruent to triangle PQR? We require this angle. So from here, we are going to get this angle. So angle ABC you can write. ABC you can write, no issues. Equal to triangle PQR. Okay, by CPCTC. By CPCTC, okay. Now you have got this angle as well equal to this angle.
Sir, why did you put ABC and PQR?
Okay. See here, we can write ABD equal to PQS. Yes. But in bigger triangle, we will require ABC equal to PQR. The triangle these angles are same, PQS or PQR. You can name it. But at last, we will require this one. So either you can do one more thing. First, you can write ABD equal to PQS. Okay. Now you can write angle ABC equal to angle PQR. Okay. No issues with that. Because the angle remains same, whether you name it ABD or ABC, PQS or PQR. Okay. Angle is same. Okay. Now we'll take the bigger triangles, triangle ABC and triangle PQR. Okay. AB equal to PQ given, BC equal to QR given, and this we have already proved. Angle ABC equal to angle PQR. So which theorem we have used here?
Sir, SAS.
Side, angle, side, SAS theorem. So by SAS theorem, these two triangles are congruent. SAS theorem. Okay, we have proved them to be congruent. Have you all understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's try ninth one now. Everyone try ninth one till I rub it. Read the question properly. Information is provided in question. Read it and try. See how you are going to prove them to be congruent. Everyone try ninth one. In your notebook, try it. And it is given two lines are parallel. When two lines are parallel, use the properties of parallel lines. A third line is cutting. So alternate interior angles. Mainly, you are going to use alternate interior angles. Okay, in the following figure, AP, BQ are equal and parallel to each other. They are equal as well, parallel to each other. So A, P, O, B, Q. So we are having two lines, AB, BQ, and then these. Okay, what are given parallel? AP and BQ. They are equal and parallel to each other. They are equal and parallel to each other. Okay. Now we have to prove triangle AOP and triangle POQ. AOP and BOQ, they are congruent. So how can you prove them to be congruent? This is given, AP is parallel to QB. Or BQ, AP and BQ are parallel and equal. How are you going to prove? One thing is given, AP is equal to BQ.
Okay. So we can take the angles.
Angles as well. So first, what is given? AP equal to BQ. This is given. Okay. AP equal to BQ. Okay. Now, here you can take angles here. Right. Okay. So which angle you are going to take first?
Sir, APO equal to BQO.
A. Angle A, B. See here, these two lines are parallel. Third line is cutting. It means, okay, let's mark first. It means these two lines are parallel. Third line is cutting. This angle will be equal to this angle. Okay. As well, these lines are parallel. This line is cutting. This angle equal to this angle. And as well, they are opposite angles. So any two angles you can use. Any two angles you can use. Here, extra information is provided. That is all the three angles we can. So among these three, any two you can take. One side is always required. One side we already taken. Now any two angles you can take. Any two angles you can take. Is this clear? So if you are taking angle APO, then APO, BQO. What is the reason? Alternate interior angles as AP parallel to BQ. Okay. Third, either you can take this angle equal to this angle, alternate interior angles, both lines are parallel. Or you can take this angle, AOP equal to BOQ, because they are opposite angles. This is up to you, which angle you take. Okay, either you take angle PAO equal to angle PAO, it means QBO, QBO. Same reason. Okay, or you can take angle AOP equal to angle BOP. Okay, they are opposite angles. Okay. Any one you can take. So three angles were there, any two you can take. Okay. So by which, okay. So which one you will prefer? If you are taking this side, this angle and this angle, which time it will be AAS. If you are using this angle and this side, it will be ASA. Okay. Depending on your theorem will vary. If you are using these three angles, one side, angle, angle. It means this angle, this, and this. So it will be by ASA theorem. If you are using this angle, It will be AAS. AAS theorem. Understood now? If we are using this angle, then it will be by ASA theorem. These two triangles will be congruent by ASA theorem. If you are using opposite angles, then it will be by AAS theorem. Okay. That you can, that's up to you, which angle you are taking. Okay. So, right at last, these two triangles are congruent. Okay. Is this clear? Everyone have understood? Anyone have doubt? If you have doubt, do ask.
No, sir, no doubt.
Okay. Now, what next we have to prove? AP and BQ.
Second angle in this.
Yes, you can take. You can take these two angles as well. Again, it will be AAS. Yes.
No, sir, in the second point is given APO and BOQ. Yes. We can take it.
These three angles, any two you can take. It's up to you. You can take these two angles. You can take these two angles. Or you can take these two angles. That's up to you. Okay. That's up to you. Any two angles you can take. Among these three angles, you can take any two. This is clear? Among these three, you can take any two. That's up to you. Okay. Okay. Now, next, what we have to prove? AP and PQ. That is, AP and PQ, they bisect each other. They bisect each other. When two lines are bisecting each other, it means... If two lines are bisecting, it means this line is bisecting, these two parts will be equal. And these two parts will be equal. Have you understood this one? If two lines are bisecting, this part will be equal to this part. This part will be equal to this part. And now what we have to prove? That they are bisecting each other. That is, AB is bisecting PQ. So first, what we have to prove? AO equal to BO. Or we can prove AO equal to OB. BO equal to OQ. How we can prove? By CPCDC we can prove. Both the triangles are congruent. Therefore, so here you write they are congruent. And now we have to prove AB and PQ, they are bisecting. How we are going to prove? AO equal to, you can write OB or BO, that's up to you. Okay, I'm writing BO. Okay. AO equal to OB. Okay, PO I have written. OB is fine. AO equal to OB or BO, that's up to you. Okay. AO equal to OB. PO equal to OQ. PO equal to OQ. This is by CPCTC. CPCTC. Okay. Now, as they are equal, it means AB and PQ, they are bisecting each other. AB and PQ, they are bisecting each other. Okay. Is this clear? So, O is the midpoint of both the lines. Okay. Since they are equal, it means AB and PQ, they are bisecting each other. Okay. Is this clear? Okay. This question is clear. Anyone have doubt in 9th? Okay, then try 10th one. Everyone try 10th one. Good. Okay, try 10th one. Go through the question. Read the question properly and try it. Yes, Sophia, attend the class properly and do study as well, okay? So which pages are you flipping in class? Okay, 10th question. In the following figure, OA equal to OC, it is given. okay, OA equal to OC, AB equal to BC, okay. So do you remember what kind of figure is it? It's kite. Kite placed horizontally. It's kite. Okay. So this is there and midpoint. Okay. A, B, C, D, and here is the O. Okay. And what more is given? This equal to this. And this equal to this. Okay. Now in the following figure, OA equal to OC, it is already marked. AB equal to BC is already marked. Now, first we have to prove angle AOB. AOB. This is 90 degrees. AOB is 90 degree, we have to prove. Okay, so with red I'm marking what we have to prove, okay? Remember, this we have to prove that this is 90 degree. Angle AOB is 90 degree. This we have to prove. Okay, so how we are going to prove this angle is 90 degree? Okay, see here, at this point, what is this angle? How much is this angle?
180 degrees.
Okay, if I prove this angle is equal to this angle, if I prove this angle equal to this angle, it means each angle will be how much?
90 degrees.
Because if I prove these two angles are equal, it means it will be half of 180, this will be half of 180, 90 degrees. So we have to prove first these two angles are equal. It means first I have to prove angle AOB equal to angle this one. These two angles are equal. We have to prove. Okay. Or we can prove these two angles are equal. So if I take these two angles are equal, it won't be easy for me to prove since no information is provided. Okay. That is to prove these two triangles are congruent, no information is provided. But if I prove these two triangles are congruent, okay, so I'm marking with green now. If I prove first triangle and second triangle, these two are congruent. If we prove these two triangles are congruent, we can prove this angle will be equal to this angle. It means each will be equal to 90 degrees. And we can prove this angle to be 90 degrees. Understood? Okay.
Yes.
This time Sophia is going to tell me. Yes, Sophia, start proving. We have taken the triangle AOB, okay? Mainly, whichever 90 degree, always take the middle one, okay? It will be very easy. And triangle AOB we have taken, COB. Sophia? Yes, Sophia, answer it. In class, he used to speak a lot. Online class, I don't know most of the students what has happened to them. In class, they used to speak a lot. Sophia, Neil, where is Neil? Now it's your chance to speak up. Speak up. Okay, so let's start. Okay, anyone can tell. These two triangles we have to prove to be congruent. So can you figure out which theorem we are going to use?
SSS theorem.
Yes. Okay. So what is given? AB equal to CB. Okay. It's given. Second, AO equal to CO. Again given. Given, both are given. Third one, where is the third one?
OB equal to OB.
Why?
Common side.
It's common side. It's the same side.
The
common. Common side. Common to both the triangles. Okay. So by SAS theorem, these two triangles are congruent. These two triangles are congruent by SSS theorem. We have proved them to be congruent. But what we need? We need to prove that these two angles are equal. Therefore, angle AOB equal to angle COB. Okay. Both are equal and both will be equal to how much? Half of 180 degree. Because this will be one angle AOC is a straight line. Okay. By CP, CTC. Okay. More reasons if you want to write, you can write AC is a straight line, O is a point, angle around the point is 180 degree, therefore half of it will be 90 degree. Now you can prove angle AOB equal to 90 degree. Understood this one?
Yes, sir.
This reason is fine, okay? This is fine, okay? Now second one, triangle AOD. Okay, now we have to prove triangle AOD congruent to triangle COD. Now you can easily prove. Okay, triangle AOD and triangle COD. Okay, how we can prove? Try to figure out how we can prove these two triangles as congruent.
Sir, AD is common.
AD or OD?
OD.
OD. Okay, OD is common. We are having the common OD. And AO equal to CO is given. One more thing we require. Side we can't take.
Sir, AD is equal to AOB.
Angle
is equal to angle COD.
Okay, these two angles, they are 90 degrees. These two are also equal now. 90. As we have proved, this angle is 90, this angle is 90. It means the remaining, these two angles will be as well equal. Yes or no? If this is 90, it's opposite. Okay, there are many ways to prove this one. If this is 90, now again angle on a line, this will be 90. This is 90, this will be 90. Or opposite to this, 90. Opposite to this, 90. Any way we can prove, that's up to you. Okay. Or even that is not required to say. Since you have written here 90, therefore these are 90. Okay. So first one, OD equal to OD, common. Okay. Second, AO equal to CO, it's given. Third one, angle AOD equal to angle COD. Okay. You can write here equal to 90. That is sufficient. It's already understood the reason. It's 90 degree. Okay. So by which theorem we have used? These two triangles are congruent by which
theorem?
SAS theorem. SAS. Included angle. Okay. Triangle COD. SAS theorem. This is clear. Okay. Now prove AD equal to CD. How you can prove that? AD equal to CD.
CPCTC.
We have proved these two triangles are congruent. Remaining every part will be equal. Every curve spring part. So CD equal to AD equal to CD. AD equal to CD. CP, CTC. Discussion is clear? Okay.
Yes, sir. Right?
Okay. Everyone, it's clear? Okay. So try 11th one now. Go through the. I'll wait for 2 minutes. Try it. Everyone try it, then we'll do on board. Here, everyone must try it always. Okay. In mathematics class, always have your fair notebook along with you and try in that. Okay. Keep trying. If you make mistake, just cross it and try it again. Okay. And don't use whitener. Don't waste your time in using whitener. Just cross it with a line. And don't mind the mistakes. How many mistakes you make? Doesn't matter. Okay. Let it be there in notebook. Okay. So key, always have the pen and the notebook. In every subject, do keep it. Apeksha, have you understood? 10th question. Apeksha. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do have the notebook. Everyone do have the notebook along with you. From the first day I have been telling. And keep solving. Okay. Try to figure out how we are going to prove these things. Okay. Following for ABC. AB equal to AC. It is given AB equal to AC. Okay. M is the point on AB and N is the point on AN. Such that BM equal to. BM equal to. So we are marking here. BM equal to CN. CN. Okay, this is given. I'm writing here what all things are given to us. AB equal to AC. So AB length is equal to AC. So it's an isosceles triangle. Remember, it's an isosceles triangle. Okay, wherever required, we can draw two figures. Okay, wherever they are overlapping, we can draw two figures to figure out how they are congruent. Okay, and BM equal to CN. BM equal to CN. This is given. Okay. AB equal to AC, BM equal to CN. These things are given. Okay. As AB equal to BC, it's an isosceles triangle. It means this whole angle is equal to this whole angle. Is this clear? So I'm marking with green this time. Okay. As AB equal to AC, it means this whole angle is equal to this angle. Okay. And what more is given? BM equal to CN. BM equal to CN. Okay. Now, first we have to prove AM equal to AN. AM equal to AN. This we have to prove. How can you can prove? It's very easy. Yes. Okay. See here. What is given to us? AB. Okay. What we have to prove first? AN equal to AM first. It is written. AM equal to AN. We have to prove. They are equal. It means these two are equal. AM equal to AN. Okay. So what is given? AB equal to AC. It is given. If we from this, we subtract this one. And from AC, we subtract this one. Are they equal? As it is given, okay. Now, if we subtract AB minus BM equal to AC minus CN. And here you have to write BM equal to CN. We are subtracting the same equal quantity. Yes, from AB and AC, we are subtracting the equal quantity because AB equal to CN. For example, AB is 5 centimeters, AC will be 5 centimeters, and what is given? MB, BM equal to CN. Maybe if it is 3 centimeters, CN will be 3 centimeters. If we subtract, how much we are getting? 2 centimeters equal to 2 centimeters. We are subtracting the same quantity, 3 centimeters, 3 centimeters. That is just for example. Okay. So, next step we can write. AM equal to AN. This you already know. This we can easily get AB minus NB, AC minus NC. It means these two are equal. Understood? Okay, second part we'll do afterwards. Okay, second, third, fourth. Way. Triangle AMC. AMC congruent to triangle this one. Okay, try it yourself. These two triangles you are going to get. Here A and B, and here these two triangles A, M, C. Okay, so we have already proved this AB equal to AC. This is given. AN equal to AM. We already here. Okay. What about this angle? It's a common angle. You can prove easily by SAS theorem. Okay. Similarly, try all the other things. Okay. Is this clear? So we'll try this part tomorrow. Okay. Have you understood how to prove? Okay. Similarly, third part you can do BN. Okay. Since these two triangles are common, it means these two will be equal. BN equal to CM. Okay. Now, after in last part, BMC. Again, draw the triangle BMC. So, see here, BMC. And here we have BNC. Okay. How you can prove? This angle will be equal to this angle. We already, okay. This is common side. Common side. Okay. And this we already have. Okay. So, you can prove. Draw them separately and try to figure out. Okay. So, try it. Okay. 11th and 12th, you try and we'll do it in tomorrow in class. Okay. Okay. So, we stop the class. Any doubt you have? If you don't have, you can leave the class. Anything you want to ask? Okay. Jayavardhan, don't start the class at 8:08. Okay. Yesterday, you sat in class for 1 hour. Don't be like that. Okay.